Hey guys, hope you all been really well. I know it's been a couple months since I've posted anything. It's just been a hectic winter. Haven't really shot a lot. And then kind of when I had some time to shoot, it was minus 40 for a couple weeks around here. Warmed right up. Now we got brown season, but we're in March and we have this beautiful snowstorm that is rolling through. And honestly, just really excited to get back out and kind of take some photos. But I'll bring you guys along with me. And quick plug for my new gallery. I did get to the Rockies this winter. Tried to film some vlogs, just again, minus 26. It was kind of roughly the average temperature during the morning. And I just did not feel like submitting my camera equipment to that and my hands every single day. So I'm sorry, but you're gonna have to just enjoy the photos without the behind the scenes vlog. So I will link that gallery in the description below. For now though, let's just get into this photo before this kind of conditions kind of wane off. So I'd be surprised if this was the last photo I take today. Kind of when I want to get this shot here. So essentially what I really like about this scene, and I don't know if you can see here, let me just turn this up a bit. So there we go. We have this bottom right here, which acts as kind of a base, an anchor for these trees to come out of. And then we have these aspen trees that are coming straight up out of it, and there's nice separation between them. Now what I like about it is actually that there are fairly busy over kind of essentially the two-thirds, and there's this gap, and there's this guy right here that's holding that left side, and these guys kind of all lean towards him, the branches. So it kind of tells a cool story. What you can't really see here is the background is kind of a red, there's some red brush back there. And so it's kind of covered in white snow as well. So it's going to be a really nice high key image. I'm going to try to edit that way. So real quick tip on capturing snow. So a couple of things you can do. First, if you stop down to say, right now I'm at F16, that's going to give you basically the frozen kind of snow particles, because you have essentially a lot of depth of field. You do have to slow your shutter speed down to about a 60th, 90th of a second, which means the ISO jumps up really high. If you kind of wanted more of a blurry ethereal effect, so something that's almost akin to fog, essentially like this, where everything kind of just blurs out, then you're kind of looking at that shallow depth of field. So this is like f 4.8, and the shutter speed is really kind of irrelevant. So let's just do an example here. Turn this down. We don't necessarily need ISO 800 here. So let me just change that to 100 and get our shutter speed to about 60th of a second. So 5 second timer. There it is. So absolutely no snowflakes in that image. Whereas if you do stop down to F16, you do get snowflakes. So you can see the difference in the background, especially when it gets lighter. You can see the streaking snow here. So likely what I'm gonna do is kind of blend a couple of these together and try and get the best of both worlds. So hope you guys enjoy the photo. Here it is. Thank you. snow's still coming down. The wind's picked up, so I don't think the snow will stick around on the trees that much longer, but it's really nice. Honestly, it's amazing how much that just a few inches of snow will change the landscape completely. I honestly don't even know why I'm shooting the scene. Something about it I enjoy. It's not particularly a beautiful photo, but that's the joy of these videos, is you get to see my garbage and some really average photos. So this is my probably going to be garbage, but I'd love to hear your guys' opinion if this is something that kind of resonates for you. But essentially what we have is this center aspen tree that's fairly symmetrical, and then on either side we have these aspen that lean away from it. And so really it's a cool photo of symmetry, and I think the only reason it might work is because of the snow. It's really kind of softened that background and made it fairly high key so that it's more a white and white image with all that symmetry. I think it could work, which is why we set up the camera out, but I do have my doubts once we get to the computer. So we'll see. But for now, I'm going to grab this photo. You guys are watching. And wipe off all that snow. It is a losing battle today, my friends, a losing battle. There's water everywhere. It's funny, you think, hey, it's going to be like a snowstorm. Bring your stupid lens hood. No. Why would I bring a lens hood? Lens hoods are for wimps, right? I'd rather just wipe my lens and make a mess of every single photo. That makes sense. Tip number two when shooting snowstorms, bring a lens hood. All right, let's see the photo. Guys, this camera has just about had it, so we're gonna end the video here. I'll probably wander around and grab some more photos, but I will be throwing up a bonus photo for anyone that's kind of stuck around. Just the drone was looking down on some ice floating around the river, and so I grabbed some of those kind of that ice breaking up in a photo. So I hope you guys enjoyed that one. We'll be at the end. And honestly, thank you so much for watching at all. It's kind of crazy that anyone would tune into a redneck hillbilly from Saskatchewan in the middle of nowhere, flat barren prairie. Just to watch a video about him taking some photos. So honestly, really appreciate you watching. And until next time, guys. Cheers. Thanks for watching.